class 9th. In the class, I have started chapter 1, rational and irrational number. And we have done some questions of 1.1 exercise. And 1.2 exercise is not so important. That's why I'm not taking that exercise. I have started in this video exercise 1.3. And see question number 1 of this. Question number 1 is, locate root 10 and root 70 on the number line. You know how to make the number line, but here the number line is something different. So what do we do? We'll write down root 10 over here. We have to think of two numbers whose sum of squares is equal to 10. So 10 can be divided as 1 square plus 3 square. Because 1 square is 1 only and 3 square is 9. So 9 plus 1 is 10. We have to locate this root 10 on the number line. So what we'll do? We will draw a number line. Number line should have arrow on both the side. And because these are positive numbers, so we can start from here 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We know that in Pythagoras theorem, h square, or we can say h is equal to p square plus b square. Means perpendicular square plus base square. So here we have divided this root 10 in 1 square plus 3 square. So perpendicular is 1 and the base is 3. Perpendicular. So at this 0 point, we will draw 1 centimeter line. And then b square base is 3. So from here to here it is 3. So we will join this line over here. This is base 0 to 3, means this 3 centimeter, 3 units, and the perpendicular is 1 unit. So the value of this hypotenuse, this h will be equal to root 1 square plus 3 square, which is equals to under root 10. So this is the line, or we can say this is the line whose length is root 10. So what do? We will take the length from here to here through your compass. Take the compass and take this distance from here to here, and keeping the, or taking this point as center, we will draw this over here. So whatever the point will come on this number line, this length will be under root 10. Understood, children, how to locate under root 10 on the number line. So here the second number is root 17. So root 17 can be written as 1 square plus 4 square, because 1 square is 1 only and 4 square is 16. So 16 plus 1 is 17. So here also on a number line, you can take this 4 as the base or perpendicular also. Same with this line 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At this point, we will draw 1 centimeter line and we will join this point from 4. And whatever the length will come from here to here, we will measure through the compass. Keeping the point, taking this point as center, we will draw an arc on this number line, and wherever this number line arc will intersect the number line, this total length will be under root 17. So this is how you have to locate under root 10, under root 17, or any other number on the number line. Now question number 2. Write the decimal expansion of each of the following numbers and say what kind of decimal expansion are each has. So 36 upon 100 is there. So if we divide 36 by 100, we get 0.36. No other numbers are coming, so this is called terminating expansion. Terminating numbers. Now 2 upon 9 is second part of the question, and if we divide 2 by 9, we have to put the decimal because 2 is less than 9, we get 1 0. 9 2's are 18, remainder is 2, a decimal is already here, so we can put 1 0. 9 2's are 18, so 2 remainder is coming, and this can be written as 0.2222 or 2, so on. So this kind of number where the same number is repeating, we can write that these are non-terminating numbers. Understood, children? In this, no denominator, no numbers are repeating. 0.36 is the answer. So this is terminating number, and 2 upon 9, when we keep on dividing 2 by 9, we are getting 0.2222 up to so on. So these kind of numbers are called non-terminating numbers. Now see question number 3 of 1.3 exercise. In this question, without actual division, state whether the following rational numbers are terminating or non-terminating decimal expression. So here in these question, what you will do is you will find out the factors of the denominator. 3, 1, 2, 5 is the number, because this number is divisible by 5. 3, 1, 2, 5, it is not divisible by 2, neither it is divisible by 3. So it is divisible because the last digit is 5, so it is divisible by 5. 5, 6 are 30, 5, 2 are 10, and then 5, 5 is 25. 6, 25 is again divisible by 5. So 5, 1 is 5, 5, 2 is 5, 5 is, and 5, again 125 is divisible by 5. 25 is coming, then 5, 5 is 25. So this number 13 upon 3, 1, 2, 5 can be written as 13 upon 5 raised to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times. So 5 raised to the power 5. So in these question, you have to see if the denominator is the product of 2 raised to the power n multiplied by 5 raised to the power n. M and n can be any natural number. So here, if the denominator is the product of 2 and 5, or single number 5, or 2 raised to the power any number, then it is terminating decimal expression. So here 13 upon 3125 is terminating decimal expression. Now see the second part of this question. Here the fraction is 23 upon 75. So we'll do the factors of 75. And 75 goes by 3. So 3 2's are 6, 3 5's are 15. 25 is divisible by 5. So 5 5's are 25. So here the denominator is 3 multiplied by 5 squared. 5 is coming, but this is not 2. So this kind of fraction is non-terminating. Wherever you see that the denominator is not the product of 2 to the power m and multiplied by m, 5 to the power n, if other than 2 and 5 any number is there, then that fraction is non-terminating. So 23 upon 75 is non-terminating decimal expression. Other parts are also given in this question, so I think you will solve other parts of this question easily if you will understand the factors 2 raised to the power n multiplied by 5 raised to the power n. Other than 2 and 5, any number is there, see in second one, 3 was there, so this is not terminating. So 3, any other number, if it is there in denominator, the factor, then that is not terminating. Now see the other question, starting 1.4 exercise also. So in this, the first question is simplify the following. The first one is under root 45 minus 3 under root 20 plus 4 under root 5. So what we have to do? We have to factors, do the factors of 45. 45 can be written as 3 into 3 into 5, because 3 3 is a 9, 5 is a 45 will come. And similarly, 20 can be written as 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5. 2 2's are 4, 5's are 20. Plus 5 is prime number, it has no factor, so root 5 like this only. And now, out of these 2, 3, because this is 9 and the square root of 9 is 3, so 3 will come out of this third sign. So 3 root 5 minus 3 multiplied by this 2 will come out, root 5 plus 4 root 5. So here 3 root 5 minus 3 to the 6 root 5 plus 4 root 5. So here 4 root 5 and 3 root 5 are positive numbers. So 3 plus 4 is 7 and 7 minus 6 is 1. So only 1 root 5 is 3. Answer. Now second part of this, third part I am taking. In this, 6 root 5 multiplied by 2 root 5 is there, and when we multiply same number with root sign, the root sign is removed. So here 6 2's are 12 multiplied by root 5 into root 5 is 5. So 12 5's are 60. 60 is the answer to this question. Now the third, this is fourth part of the question. Now fourth part, in this 8 root 15 divided by 2 root 3. So it can be written as 8 root 15 multiplied by 1 upon 2 root 3. So this 8 can be cancelled by 2, 2 and 2, 2 was the 8. Root number can also be cancelled. So 15 can be cancelled by 3. 3 into 3, 3 5 is a 15. So here the answer is 4 root 5. This is the answer. Now I hope you have understood the question of 1.3 and 1.4 exercise, and this video will help you to solve the questions of these exercises. Kitne ho gaye?